women's budget group, and we spend our time trying to investigate the gender impact of policies. The main thing I want to say is that it's really important when you're planning policies to think about their equality impact. In fact, the last Labour government brought in legislation that required the government to do that. It hasn't actually been doing much of that over the last two governments, neither the coalition government nor the Conservative government. But I also have to say I haven't heard a lot of discussion today about the equality impact policies that are being discussed. I agree with the general direction of the policies being proposed. We do need to develop anti-austerity policies, and public investment in infrastructure is the way to do it. We need it for a more balanced economy, and I've listened with interest to the debates about the best way to pay for this, whether it's by increased taxation, borrowing, or people's QE. But I think we need a concept of infrastructure that's much broader than the one that's being talked about. It's been restricted largely today to a conventional notion of physical infrastructure, that the only way to invest in the future and raise productivity is through building more things, roads, bridges, high-speed trains, or high-speed broadband. And I'm not arguing against these proposals. I think they're all good ideas. But I think we're in even more dire need of a different form of investment, and that's investment in our social structure, social infrastructure. Investment in our health, education and care systems, and that would build people's productivity and their capacities more generally. It is investment is anything whose benefits outlast the current period. And when the benefits have a public good character, then we talk about it as infrastructure. Well-functioning health, education, training, child and social care systems are some of the most important parts of our national infrastructure. Their benefits accrue to us all and affect all our futures. So spending on employing teachers, child and social care workers and healthcare professionals should be seen as an investment in our social infrastructure just as much as spending money on employing building workers and engineers is spending on our physical infrastructure. Do you remember there used to be talk about Plan B, an alternative to Plan A? Well, we've come up with a plan, we skipped a few letters of the alphabet and came up with a Plan F, a fiscal and economic strategy based on significant public investment in social infrastructure. The idea would be to foster a self-funding, caring and sustainable economy with greater gender equality. This would require creating health and education systems, reforming our health and education system to promote the long-term viability of our population, but also creating another national system to match these, a national care system covering both child and social care, not having the piecemeal chaotic system that we have now. Now, this is a special pleading for an industry that I happen to be particularly interested in, but is not particularly economically important. I don't know if you know, but the care industry is the fastest growing industry, not only in the UK, but in every developed economy. It does a vital job that we cannot afford to leave for dogmatic ideological reasons in the hands of unscrupulous private for-profit providers and the complex networks of finance capital. Produces high quality care for children and for the adults who need it, and that treats and trains its workers well. And let's see that as the major infrastructure project for the next Labour government. There's another point. Investment in care is an exceptionally efficient way of creating jobs, and of course in improving the gender employment gap. So research that was done at Women's Budget Group for the International Trade Union Confederation showed that in the UK, investing in care produced twice as many jobs as investing the same amount of money in construction. It produces almost as many jobs for men as construction, and of course far more for women. So while if you go for investing in infrastructure through construction projects, you will be worsening the gender employment gap. One can do various things to try and mitigate that, but nevertheless, it's very unlikely you won't be worsening the gender employment. Investing in care, you will improve the gender employment gap, and in the long run, hopefully can improve the way that women are segregated into the care industry and men don't get a chance to do that sort of very rewarding work. I'm not against physical infrastructure projects, though we need to choose sensible ones. But even with extensive efforts made to challenge existing employment practices and gender norms, any increased investment in projects based on construction is likely to worsen gender inequalities. So we also need to invest in our social infrastructure because it has good effects on our gender vision. But the main case for investing in our social infrastructure is based on its direct benefits in having a healthier, better educated and cared for population, and more secure because of having well-functioning care, education and health systems. And on environmental grounds, I have to say that I think this is the only route to a better future. We can't go on producing and consuming more things. In fact, we'll have to spend our time, more of our time, caring for each other and learning how to care for each other.